Hello all, and welcome to this AWS tutorial. In our tutorial today, we will discuss about Amazon Aurora Backtrack and see how we can rewind database changes. Let us begin with, what is Amazon Aurora Backtrack? Backtracking is an ability to undo or rewind changes made on a DB cluster to a specific time without restoring data from a backup. So let's say typically if you had to undo any changes that were made on your database cluster or even on database, you would have to, you know, go and get a backup or restore a snapshot or perform any of those two operations, right? But what Backtrack allows you to do is, it simply allows you to rewind all the changes and bring the database cluster to the state at a specific point in time. And all that you need to do is specify that, hey, I want this database cluster to go back to the state when it was at 2 p.m. today, right? Without doing any restoring of data, without getting any tapes, without getting any snapshots and performing a restore or anything of that sort. You can backtrack a DB cluster back and forth in time to help determine when a particular change occurred. That means that, let's say you made certain changes to your database, right? And you made those changes today afternoon. And you feel that, hey, I need to just rewind all the changes, let's say to early morning today, about 10 a.m. So you backtrack your database, let's say from right now it is 4 p.m., you go back to 10 a.m. and you just backtrack it by a few hours. Then you realize that, hey, maybe, you know, I made a few changes after that, and some of the changes that were done by me before noon were valid, and probably I should go ahead by 1 hour. That means instead of starting from 10 a.m. and doing all those changes that you did from 10 to 11, you say that, hey, just go back to the state you were at 11 a.m. That means you can backtrack the changes back and forth. That means essentially, let's say you can go back to 10 a.m., then go ahead by 1 hour to 11 a.m. Let's say you may feel that, hey, all the changes that were done around 11 a.m. were good. Why don't we go back to 2 p.m. and see what maybe everything that was done until 2 p.m. was right? And then you realize maybe that was not. So can I go back to 1:30 or 1:15? So that is possible. So hence, backtracking gives you the ability to move or change the database state or go back and forth in time as you desire. Okay, so if you want to go back in time by a few hours, maybe come forth by a few hours from where you had backtracked to, you could certainly do that as well. So for example, you can backtrack a DB cluster for 5 hours and then take it forward by 1 hour. Hence, the total backtrack will be 4 hours from the original time. So let's take another example over here, right? So let's say today is 13th of October, 2019. And I launched a DB cluster at around 10 a.m. Then I created a database somewhere around noon. Then I created a table somewhere around 2 p.m. Then I inserted records somewhere around 4 p.m. And right now it is, let's say, 6 p.m. Now I want to go back to the state of this database, let's say, around 1 p.m. So I say, hey, backtrack this to 1 p.m. right here. Then I realized that, hey, my DB was created very well. It's created successfully. There's nothing wrong. You know what? Let's move further ahead. Let's move it to 3 p.m. over here. Slowly, you can move further ahead. So as you see, I backtracked this particular database to 1 p.m. I saw that my changes were done. Whatever I had done till 1 p.m. was right. I wanted to go and check the state of the database at 3 p.m. because I'd created my table approximately around 2 p.m. And then I said, hey, this is good. So any changes probably after 3 p.m. were no good for me. So basically, I could backtrack it and then bring it forth by a few hours as well. So I can basically say that, hey, I want this database now at the state it was at 3 p.m. today. So you could move back and you could again move it forth depending upon how many hours you have backtracked. So from the original time, that is 6 p.m., I have only backtracked by 3 hours because I brought it back to 3 p.m. So I backtracked it by 3 hours only. Correct? So I hope that this is clear. How is backtrack different from restoring a database? Backtrack is different from restoring a database to a point in time because restoring a database creates a new DB cluster and restores it from a backup that you have, a database backup, or you will have to create a new DB cluster from the snapshot. And obviously, this particular operation can take hours to finish. On the other hand, backtracking a DB cluster doesn't require a new DB cluster to be created. It actually performs the action on the existing database cluster. And the best part, it finishes in a few minutes, right? So you don't have to go about hunting for a restore or a tape or whatever else that you're trying to figure out over here, okay? Or even a snapshot. And you don't need to create a new instance. Basically, you get the ability to just backtrack the existing cluster and the whole change happens in a few minutes. So that's the best part. Some additional info on backtracking. Backtracking is currently only supported for Aurora MySQL 5.6. Now, obviously, this can change after I finish recording this video, but while I'm recording or when I'm recording this video, this is only available for Aurora MySQL 5.6. You need to enable backtracking when you launch the DB cluster. So you can only enable this feature while you're launching the DB cluster. This is a key, not after you have launched a DB cluster. Remember, backtracking affects the entire DB cluster. That means you cannot just backtrack a single table. You can only backtrack the whole DB cluster, okay? The time limit for backtracking is 72 hours. That means you can only backtrack changes for 3 days or 72 hours. This is the max limit. Obviously, you can always set it to 24 hours, 48 hours, or X amount of hours, as long as the number of hours are less than 72. Backtracking causes a brief DB instance disruption. Obviously, the service is not going to be available for the time that the database is being backtracked. With backtracking, there's a target backtrack window and the actual backtrack window. The target backtrack window is the amount of time you want to be able to backtrack your DB cluster. Let's say you want to be able to backtrack your DB cluster by 72 hours or 48 hours or 36 hours or something like that. So that's your target backtrack window. The actual backtrack window is the actual amount of time you can backtrack your DB cluster, okay? So your actual backtrack window, depending upon how much time your cluster has been up, although the backtrack window is 72 hours, but if your DB cluster is only up for 24 hours, you will only be able to backtrack it for 24 hours. This is the actual backtrack versus the target backtrack window. As your DB cluster stays, available, okay, this particular actual backtrack window will almost be equal to your target backtrack window. Depends upon how many hours it is. And also, the number of hours that you can or you actually backtrack typically, or in most of the cases, would be lesser than the target backtrack window, right? So your target backtrack window is 72 hours, but your actual backtrack window or the time that you wanted to actually backtrack this would only be 4 hours. Okay, so I only wanted to backtrack it by 4 hours. So typically it will be smaller than your target backtrack window, but it could be equal as well. Applicability. To get database to a specific state in the last 72 hours. Like, hey, I want this database to go back to, let's say, what it was on 10/11 at 1 p.m. I could do that, assuming that I had set up the target backtrack to 72 hours. I can undo any changes that had performed. Okay, so that basically, let's say I want to undo a few changes. So I backtrack, right? I go back to 1 p.m. I bring it forward to 3 p.m. So I undid a few changes from, let's say, if I was at 6 p.m., I undid changes for the last 3 hours over here. Understand when a specific change was made. So let's say if I wanted to track that, hey, something went wrong with this database. Some changes were made. When was this change made? I could do that. I could debug that by backtracking and, you know, going back and forth and figuring out when a specific change was made, because I can bring this cluster exactly to a specific point in time. Let's say I want this cluster to be how it was at 2 p.m., maybe at 3 p.m. And then I say, hey, 2 p.m. this change was not there. 3 p.m. this change was there. That means the change occurred between 2 and 3. Let's move it back to 2:30. It was not there at 2:30. Can we move it forth to 2:45? It was there at 2:45. So I know that now this change was made between 2:30 and 2:45. And I can probably figure that out, that here when that exact change was done. Maybe I bring it to 2:40 and figure out that the change was done at 2:41. So that's a possibility. You could understand when a specific change was made. Application testing or creating any test data, right? So typically when you are trying to create a test data, you will create your test data, you run a test cycle. And then you want to, again, either run a script or remove all the data or create a brand new database, depending upon, you know, I've seen different methods that people do. What you could do is leverage something like backtracking. Hey, the test data was available. I created a new instance. The brand new instance was created at noon. After that, I ran a test cycle. And then after I ran a test cycle, I want to rerun another cycle. I want to run cycle number 2. So instead of creating a new instance, running the scripts, et cetera, hey, can we backtrack or rewind all the changes and bring it back to the state that it was at noon, because we started testing at 1 p.m. So you could certainly do that. That way you don't have to create a separate instance or anything. You just backtrack the changes and you go ahead from there. So these are some of the areas that could, where you could potentially leverage the backtracking feature. Now, right now, this particular feature is available only with Aurora, but hopefully other databases also get inspired by this, because it's a real cool feature. I would really want this in some most popular databases that are available in the market. If only you could do something similar over there, that would be fantastic. So feel free to explore this particular feature. I will create another tutorial to demo this feature so that you can see the power of this feature, as to how powerful this particular feature is. And it's amazing, that you could just make these changes in a matter of minutes, literally minutes, and not wait for anyone or not wait to get a database snapshot or a restore or anything. So I hope that you like this session. Feel free to explore this particular feature. It's really good. Even if you don't use Aurora, just see the feature. It's really, really amazing. Okay. So thank you guys. And I will see you shortly in some other video. Take care. Bye-bye.